The official Geant4 installation guide recommends command line interface for the compilation of Geant4 on Windows. While I found that the Visual Studio graphic user interface is much more friendly for new users. The community edition of Visual Studio can be downloaded freely from Microsoft. The installation file itself is very small. Run it to start the installation. More things will be downloaded from the internet. During this process, you will be asked to choose which component or workload to be installed in your system. Scroll down and select Desktop Development with C++ and click Install. It takes quite some time to download and install the entire package. Be patient. At the end of the installation, click on OK to restart your machine. After your Windows is restarted, search for Visual Studio in your Start menu to start Visual Studio. You can use Visual Studio without signing in, so click on Not Now, Maybe Later to continue. Choose Visual C++ as your development settings and start Visual Studio. Click Continue without code to launch Visual Studio without any code in it. This is the graphic user interface of Visual Studio. If you prefer to use the command line interface, expand the Tools menu and select Visual Studio command line prompt. You can also simply search for Developer PowerShell in your Start menu to launch it directly without the graphic user interface. You will then have a terminal where you can type in command recommended in the Geant4 installation guide. To summarize, after the installation of the latest Visual Studio, you have both the command line interface and the graphic user interface. If you prefer to use the command line interface to install Geant4, please follow the official Geant4 installation guide. If you prefer to use the graphic user interface to compile Geant4, please follow my instruction on YouTube. Good luck!